cooking up. Then my windows is tinted as gold. My backseat ain't empty, we just left the Fendi. We getting it all over the place. This is why I need the fam. This is why I need.
What's up guys, it's Brittany and I'm back with another video. I'm in my pajamas and I look comfortable because I was, you know, just watching TV, but I had to quickly come on here and say this. Have you guys seen Forever Us on Tubi? So I love Lyrica. I like Lyrica. So once I saw Lyrica was in it, I wanted to watch it. I also like Zonique. So when I saw Zonique was on it, I wanted to watch it as well. So I'm just here to talk about the movie. I just wanted to get on here and talk about the movie real quick. So yeah, that's all I have. But it's your girl Brittany and I'm back with another video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, share, all that. And right here, right now, I am going to be talking about Forever Us on Tubi. Okay, so Forever Us on Tubi is about this woman named Kate and her husband, Bert. Kate is played by Lyrica. Bert is played by, I cannot think of where else I know him from. But his name is Bert and he's playing Lyrica's husband. And then we have Zonique. Her name is Bella. I'm gonna break down the plot. Okay, like I said, Kate and Bert are married. It seems like Kate is the breadwinner and I think she's in like pharmaceutical sales or something. They didn't really touch on it 100%, but I know that she has to be in something pharmaceutical because her husband at one point says something about her and her team being close to making a pill for cancer, to cure cancer. So yeah, she's in pharmaceutical sales, duh. Bert, he just seems like he just has a regular 9-to-5. He's not the breadwinner. So like I said, Kate's the breadwinner in the family. And it seems like recently she's been working a lot, which is taking time away from her family, her marriage, etc., because she's just been working so much. Their schedules don't correlate. They're not having sex. They don't have any type of romance. It seems like Bert is just, you know, kind of sad, kind of lonely. And it's starting to get to him. Like, he's starting to miss his wife. He's starting to miss this intimacy. And yeah, Bert one day is at work as he is dropping off his packages. He runs into this girl named Bella. And like I said, Bella is played by Zonique. It seems like as soon as he met Bella, that void was just starting to fill his heart. And you can just see the glow on his face when he meets Mrs. Bella. Mind you, Bert is married. So let's just take all this into consideration. Bert is married, if I missed that part. Bert is married, okay? He's married to Kate. But as soon as he meets Bella after she drops off, oh, and let me just say this, Bert and Kate also have a 17 or 18 year old daughter named Tiffany. Tiffany in the plot, but okay, back to Bert and Bella. They just instantly hit it off. At first, Bella does not know that Bert is married. So after Bert and Bella meet, she decides to, okay, something happened to her car. So he had drove Bella home. And as he drives Bella home, you know, they're conversing. Then they get to Bella's house and she invites him in for coffee. Honestly, coffee is a key point in this whole storyline too. She invites him in for coffee. She makes him coffee. They talk, they laugh and flirt, etc. And then Bert leaves because he just sees that it's getting, you know, kind of flirtatious, hot and heavy. Then afterwards, I'm gonna just speed the plot up, okay? Afterwards, Bert and Bella end up having an affair. They end up having sex. Y'all wanna know what Bert does after he cheats on his wife, Kate, with Bella? this dumbass gets in the shower and slides down, water all down him, all dramatic. And like, dude, why are you crying in the shower? You're the one that cheated. Make it make sense. I'm confused. Like, I don't get it. Like, you know what? That's a topic for another day. That's a topic for another day. Let me just stick to this storyline before, you know, I start getting beside myself. So yeah, after Bert and Bella have sex the first time, they continue to start seeing one another. They just start having a little side relationship. Out of nowhere, Bert starts making amazing coffee. One day he wakes up and it also does seem like when he's with Bella, like he's being authentic, he's being himself, he's being more comfortable around this woman and blah, blah, blah. And he feels like everything that he couldn't get, can't get, doesn't get from his marriage with Kate, he gets it from Bella. So one day, the way he is with Bella, he decides to bring that around Kate by making her coffee, having on this cute British accent, real silly and blah, blah, blah. And Kate's just like, okay, the coffee's good, but what's up with this voice? What's up with dang, what's it called that chefs wear when they cook? The apron. What's up with the apron? Blah, blah, blah. And, you know, she kind of shuts that down and you can see his demeanor just kind of goes down a little bit, like, hey, babe, I was just playing and blah, 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 blah. And so in his mind, he's probably like, man, F this. I'm about to go back to my girl, Bella. So he goes back to Bella. And when he goes to Bella, Kate finds out that he's cheating. So she follows him to Bella. Him and Bella are at this restaurant. She's feeding him and this, that, and the third. And this scene, y'all would just have to watch this movie for itself just to see the acting and the storytelling. Because in this scene, they're exposed eating and Kate's just exposed looking at them. And at this point, I'm just like, okay, like, can they all like not see each other? Because they're really sitting right in front of each other. But that's beside the point. Y'all just gotta watch the movie. So, moral of the story, Kate finds out that he is cheating. Bella asks Bert, like, hey, what does your wife do and blah, blah, blah. And Bert's just like, girl, you knew I was married and you decided to do this. So why are you trying to switch up now? Don't be asking me about my wife. You knew I had a wife. And it seemed like Bert used to be venting to Bella about his wife, but it seemed like Bella just didn't ask any questions. Because out of nowhere, when she said, oh, what does your wife do? He got offended. Like, girl, you knew I had a wife. Don't speak on my wife. I can talk shit about my wife to you, but don't you ever say anything about my wife. Typical cheater type stuff. Because it's like, but then on the same time, it's like, Bella, you were having sex with this guy. You were participating in this affair. You knew he had a wife. Like, whatever. So afterwards, Bert leaves. Kate, aka Lyrica, is walking across the street. And then Kate comes to Bella, knocks at her door, and is just like, hey, I'm Bert's wife, blah, blah, blah. They come in, they have a conversation, things start to get heated. Then Kate sees the cup, the coffee cup that Bert's been using. She picks it up. They start going back and forth, and Kate swings the hell out of that cup at her face, and then Bella dies. I heard people were saying, oh, this was an accident, blah, blah, blah. No, like, that rage of her being cheated on and seeing that girl, like, she meant to kill that girl. It probably, like, almost, she meant to kill that girl, because when I tell you, she banked the freak out of that girl's head with that cup. Like, that girl was gone. Like, that was no, like, oh my gosh, rage just hit me. Like, nah, you wanted that girl dead. The minute you saw her, you took your chance and you done killed that girl. Like, it's okay. It's okay. I would have killed the girl too. I would have killed both of them. but I would have killed her too. Out of rage, like Kate did, but you know, it's okay, it's okay. So Kate's freaking out because she has a dead body on her hands and blah blah blah. So after Kate kills Bella, you know, she's freaking out. She's trying to take care of it herself, but she can't take care of it. So she calls her husband. When she calls her husband, she says, look, I don't need you to ask any questions right now. I just need you to help me. Like, yeah, yeah, babe, what's up? And he says, she says, I'm at her house. At this point, Bert didn't know that Kate knew that he was cheating. So he comes to his girlfriend's house to see that his wife done killed his girlfriend. And he's just like freaking out. And he's just like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. And Kate's just like, bro, we have a dead body on our hands. Like, and the first thing you want to ask me is how long have I known? Like, we have a dead body on our, like, on our hands. Like, what are we going to do with this body? So Bert takes care of the body and blah, blah, blah. And then fast forward to, yeah, Bert takes care of the body. We don't know what he did with it, where he hid it. We don't know what he did with it. We just see that he's wrapping up a body. So, you know, yeah, who knows what he did with it. So at the end, it seems like Bert and Bella, they, you know, they're kind of in a better place. Bert confesses. Kate asks Bert, like, hey, why did you do this? Like, I need you to tell me why. Bert explains it to her. Then afterwards, it seems like they're fine. They buy their daughter a car. But as they give their daughter the keys to their car, police sirens come up. And Bert and Kate, they have their hands up. They're ready to surrender because, mind you, they just killed someone and hit the body. So yeah, the police is coming up and they're freaking out and blah, blah, blah. So, but the police goes to the house next door to arrest somebody, and there's kind of like a relief to them. But at the same time, they both seem kind of paranoid because it's just like, dang, like, what are we gonna do? Like, we really just got away with killing someone. Like, dang, like, the police wasn't even here for us. Like, gosh. And yeah, that was honestly the whole story. Like, of course I'm missing some things, but I really gave the main plot of it. Bert, Kate married. Bert's unhappy because Kate works a lot. Bert meets Bella. They start to have a relationship affair. Kate finds out and kills Bella. Ding! And then they get away with the murder. Ding! So yeah, moral of the story, that's all that happened. But I honestly did like the plot of the story. The acting honestly could have been better, but at the same time, these are not really actors, actresses, actresses. So I enjoyed it. I really like Lyrica. I love Lyrica. I liked her on Love & Hip Hop. I like her as an artist. I actually liked Zonique. I liked her as OMG Girls and blah, 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 and everything Zonique does. So I enjoyed the movie. I do think the acting could have been better, but you know, it was on Tubi, so it was like, it was honestly real good for a Tubi movie. Like, Tubi movies honestly been snapping lately. Like, I don't know. But yeah, I honestly enjoyed the storyline. You know, is it kind of predictable? Yes. But the unpredictable part was them getting away with the murder. Like, if they would have got arrested at the end, it would have been like, okay, cool. But there was no justice for Bella. There was no justice for Bella. Like, these people just got away with murder, gave their daughter a keys to a car. They thought the police was getting them. After the police went next door, they were kind of like, whew, sucks to be you, because we just got away with murder, nigga. Like, you know. Yeah, so honestly, Forever Us on Tubi, you know, I would recommend it. Check it out. Honestly, give it an 8 out of 10. Like I said, it was kind of the acting to me more so, yeah, it was more so the acting for me that was kind of bringing it down. Like, I feel like the deliverance of some punches could have been better, but at the same time, they would have done better than me, so it honestly doesn't matter. And like I said, yeah, it was good. So Forever Us on Tubi, I enjoyed it. And yeah, that's just how I feel about it. Yeah. But yeah, after I saw this movie, I just had to come on here and, you know, pop my crap and talk about it real quick. So, you know, I really didn't want too much because, you know, don't you guys see I'm real snuggled up and comfy? So, you know, I just had to get on here and, you know, pop that stuff real quick. So, yeah, that's all I wanted. Check out Forever Us on Tubi. And if you saw it, let's talk about it. If you didn't see it, but you're about to see it after you see this, come back to this video and let's talk about it. Like, come on. So, yeah, that's all I have. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, share. All that, baby. Don't play with it, don't be decisive.